What's going on, everybody? My name is Pizza Hitter Brendan, and welcome back to another episode of ARK here on the YouTuber Survival Evolved server. It is very gloomy, very dark right now. Probably cannot see anything, but we got some good vision, for today's episode. Now, before I get started, I have to address something that's actually kind of hilarious. Now, I don't know if a lot of you guys watching this, of course, I'll talk to you guys as a personal tone. I don't know if you keep up with the other people on the series. For example, you got the Blue Bantz boys, you got I don't know the other tribe name, apologies, they're like red and yellow with John and Rob and all them. And you got Miola, you got Choco and all them. I don't know if you guys keep up with, let's just pinpoint out John and Rob in particular here. They actually messaged me on Skype earlier and was like, yo, Pete, I think we accidentally got your Quetzal that you were after. So basically, if you guys didn't catch last episode, I found two Quetzals, okay? I found a level 34, I think, male that was flying around, and a level 17 female. Now, when I saw the level 17 female, I freaked, because I'm like, it's a female, and it's level 17. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is awesome, right? And I said to myself, and to you guys, I was like, I don't know if anybody has, like, called dibs on it. Dibs doesn't really exist unless you go to people on the server and say, hey, this is mine, don't tame it, please, or like, this is mine, don't touch it, please. I wasn't sure whether or not anybody had done that because there was no talk of it, so I'm like, if nobody else is trying to get this Quetzal, I'm gonna go ahead and get it for myself. Now, here's the thing, okay? I never said that it, like, to everybody else on the server, I'm getting this. So I didn't expect them to know. John and Rob actually later that day that I recorded it went ahead and tamed the Quetzal. Now, hey, relax. For those of you that are angry, please don't be. It's awesome that they got it because they actually had a male Quetzal that they got not too long ago, like a few days ago, actually. So they got a bride for it, and that's freaking awesome. So today, we're gonna go Quetzal hunting, trying to find another. Now, obviously, that level 17 would have been amazing, but hey, again, no hard feelings to the guys. It's freaking awesome, and again, they wouldn't have known. You know what I mean? I feel kind of bad that a couple of people from, like, my end of it, you know, like, you guys gotta understand. Some people get pretty, you know, pretty into this series, which I definitely agree with, you know what I mean? But a couple people were giving Rob and John some hard times, so being that today is the day they're likely posting their taming episode of it, don't get mad, please. That's all that I ask. Don't get mad, because I'm not mad. It's only game. Why you have to be mad? Anyways, moving on to the actual episode. So with that out of the way, ladies and gentlemen, enough talking, enough saying, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to get prepared to go Quetzal hunting, and my god, this is going to be absolutely insane. We got the beautiful music going out right now. I accidentally hit my mic. I'm gonna make sure that my mic's not messing up. So I've already had a little bit of experience in doing this. I'd mentioned that around episode 9, I tried taming a level 76 Quetzal just for the banter off camera. It did not work out very well at all, but I know exactly what I'm gonna need for this whole adventure. So the first thing that I need to go ahead and do is basically get rid of a lot of stuff in my inventory. Now, there is actually something that I got recommended last episode, and I don't know whether or not this is the thing, but I okay. So, right here, this thing is called a bookshelf. I'm gonna go ahead and learn this up right now, my engrams, and what do I need to craft this? I need 100 wood, and we already have the rest of that stuff on there. Should have some wood in my- there we go. So, a bookshelf is actually a very awesome thing. It's not a storage box, but it pretty much holds all of your blueprints rather than keeping them on you, which doesn't really make any sense at all. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this guy down, I think right over right about there sounds good. So yeah, basically you access the inventory of here, store blueprints, notes, and other small trinkets in this, slots 0 out of 100. So this right here is where we're actually going to put all of our blueprints, because it makes the most sense. To the person who wrote that comment, you know who you are, and I'm very grateful for pointing this out, because I don't know everything about this game, and you definitely saved me a bit of some headaches there. Just thought I'd show you guys this right now. We're just putting all of our blueprints in, every single blueprint we own in the game, from the two storage boxes that we had before. We're just dropping them all in right now. I think we might actually get, like, really close to the cap. Oh, are we gonna have enough? Oh my god. Oh, 100 out of 100. Oh, when the blueprint slots are, oh, just right. God, that's so freaking satisfying. Anyway, moving on right now. So let me go ahead and dump everything that I've got in my inventory, basically all into this right here, dumping everything that I've got. That is 27 items in total. So we're just going to do this so we have pretty much no weight on us right now. There's a few vital things that we're going to need for this. Now, last episode, we tried out the whole leveling secret thing. Didn't necessarily come up true, but in doing that, we have a lot of narcotics, which is going to be so, so vital for being able to do this. You need a lot of narcotics for Quetzals. Like, a lot of narcotics for Quetzals. To the point where basically, like, going, from what I've heard, you never want to leave a Quetzal unattended. So if at any point we run out of narcos and have to go back home, we basically failed. Which is not really something that I want to wind up doing this series. Is failing a Tetzel tame, a Quetzal tame. That would actually kind of really suck. So first thing you need is narcotics, and a lot of it. Second thing that you need is obviously a crossbow, but we could actually go a step further and learn up something here called tranquilizer darts. Now, I've never actually used these before. A potent dart full of tranquilizing poison for use in a long neck rifle. Cannot be used with attachments. Can only be crafted at smithy. Interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and learn this up right now. What do you need then to craft? Because this might actually be rather interesting. For those who don't know, Trank darts are much more effective than Trank arrows. Kind of makes sense right there. Smithy, weapons, ammo. What do you need for this? We need simple rifle ammo, metal ingots, and 3 narcotics. Interesting. Okay, so basically, to be able to make one of these guys, I need 3 times the narcotics and 1 simple rifle ammo. Now, the problem is with this, we don't have simple rifle ammo because, yeah, this thing right here, because we don't really have a lot of metal. Now, we could make this with the metal that we've got right now, which would give us about 48, but this is a difficult choice right now. This is definitely a difficult choice. I'm not really sure how much simple rifle ammo we can even make. Because right now we've only got 98 iron to our name. And that's it. And the whole reason that we want a Quetzal is so we can get more iron. This is what this is why solo taming a Quetzal is so difficult, man. These choices you have to make right now. So let me go and just take a look right here. How many Trank darts do I, or Trank arrows do I have on me right now? Where's our simple rifle? Or where's our long neck rifle, rather? Our long neck is, that's our apprentice pike. Long neck rifle, ramshackle one right over here. This guy is, okay, so that's you. Interesting. Where is my, what's it called? The dart, yeah, this guy right here, the crossbow. So we'll go ahead and take us out for right now. Okay, put that in my inventory. I want to make sure I've always got that. Put that in there. There we go. Now, how many Trank darts do I, or Trank arrows do I have? I have a total of what seems to be, is this, wait, hold on. 106, 119, 109, 111. Oh, no. This is the one we're using. Okay, that's the one with the scope. All right, interesting. Wait, no. No, I don't even care about the long neck rifle. I'm going with the crossbow. Never mind. Apprentice crossbow, 228 and 142. Okay, so this is the better one that we've got right now. Okay, cool. So we have a total right now of 77 Trank arrows. Not too bad, in all honesty. Like I said, we're very low on metal. We have 15 simple rifle ammo if we wanted to turn those into Trank darts right now. You know, in all honesty, I think the better thing about Trank darts is the accuracy. Because for those that don't know, I know I'm preaching a lot right now, but we got some preparation. From the practice that I've done, being up in the air, because the thing is, Quetzals, they never stop flying. You have to be above them, parachuting down and shooting. I believe if you have a Trank dart, it'll hit the target a lot faster, and you're guaranteed to land a lot more shots. I might actually, you know what? I think I'm going to invest into the Trank arrows. I think so. So what we're going to go ahead and do right now, I believe I have the metal in. Do I have all my metal in here? I do have all my metal. Let's go ahead. We're going to do a big thing, but we got to be determined in this. We'll take the gunpowder that we got right now, take all that from our inventory. We'll go ahead and bring the gunpowder over to our good old smithy. Transfer all these items up right now. There we go. For those wondering, you press T to do that. I'm not magic. I wish I was. Right. So we have that now. How many simple rifle ammo can I make at the moment? I can make a total of 98? Does 2 metal ingots give you 2 bullets? Oh. Oh. Well, that's something I didn't know. Okay, well, that's interesting. Alright, I did not actually know that. Okay, so, oh. But here's the thing, right? You need metal ingots in itself to make the tranquilizer darts. So we're probably only going to be able to make like 48. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and craft up, I think. Let me take out half the iron that I've got right now to make sure that I don't wind up crafting too many. So we'll go ahead and do... Let's split that one more time. Let's craft us a total of 24 of these guys right now. So yeah, it gives you two at a time then. Yeah, it does. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay. So we have the narcotics on us as well if we want to do this. This is a very risky route that I'm doing right now, but I think it'll probably... Who are you? What are you? You are a Diplo. What's up, Diplo? You got a Diplo. All right, so how many do we got in total? We now have a total of 24, so we got 39 in total right now, which is good. So if anything from right now, we got the metal ingots as well as the narcotics. Let's go ahead and drop those in there, drop the metal ingots, and drop a simple rifle. So for example, okay. So from what I'm seeing around here, okay, so that's the narcotics capping out right there. We're going to be able to make a total of 37 tranquilizer darts with the amount of iron that we've got, or the amount of metal that we've got on us right now. It does just take two to make one. I'm going to look up real fast and see if whether or not this is worth it, because this might actually, this may or may not be worth it. I think it will be. Let's see. Okay, let's compare it this way from what I'm looking at the wiki right now. So, if it was a level 20, for example, it would take either 25 Trank bolts, or Trank arrows, rather, and 18 of the Trank darts. So, 25 arrows or 18 darts. I'm gonna go ahead and just craft up one, and I am gonna waste it, just because I do genuinely want to see how fast this thing fires. I believe it'll fire pretty damn fast, but I am gonna go ahead and just give it a shot. So let's go and drag this guy into our inventory right now. I believe if I go ahead and do this, there we go, and drag our good old ammunition on top of it. So we now have one of the Trank darts loaded up into this guy. There we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and try shooting it from, I'm gonna try shooting this guy from right over here. Let's see how fast it travels to it. That still takes a while, actually. Are you gonna... Your toe port's not gonna go down from that, right? I know you're only level 2, but, like, you should be fine. That's... I'm gonna be honest to say, I don't really know if I want to waste the iron in it right now, but I'm not... Or metal, rather. But I don't really know if I'm making metal for anything. But in all honesty, I don't know if I want to waste the narcotics on it for right now. So I'm gonna say no to the Trank darts. We're going to say no to the Trank darts today. So the next thing I'm working on right now is getting a little bit more flint, because we're going to have to make some more arrows, obviously. And you need some flint to do that, and I actually genuinely have no flint at home. So we're gathering up a little bit of flint right now. Shouldn't honestly take too much, but I figure while I'm out here, might as well gather up pretty much all that I need right now. So yeah, one of the reasons also that I don't want to bring a Trank darts is that I know I won't have enough to wind up bringing it down, at least... I don't know how well my aim's gonna be, and a rifle weighs a lot more than an actual crossbow. So, with that said, I don't want to have to bring both and weigh down my pterodactyl, because we're gonna have to bring a lot of parachutes, and the more parachutes I can bring, the better this whole thing's gonna go. So, we basically need to make sure that we can hold our pterodactyl to as much weight as possible. But, yeah, I'll catch you guys back when we're, nearly done. Now, unfortunately, there is one more thing I'm gonna have to do to wind up preparing for this whole adventure, and that is, going a little bit of a short killing spree of some dinos right now, and I believe this parasaur that's running away from me because I just killed his friend is gonna be, well, he was gonna be one of my prime targets, but he's running away from me fast. It's like a tar land over here. This is kind of weird. Never seen this area. It's all dark and stuff. A little odd. But yeah, we need some hide, because it's in order... Is this a red? Oh my god, it's a red. Wait, it's a red beacon. Oh, this isn't fair. Oh, I don't have my pterodactyl on me and there's a red beacon. Code red. Literally code red. Oh no. Guys, this ain't good. I have stuff that I need to do. Fudge. I need to go ahead and kill you, and I need to get my guy back. Hold on, get that hide. I gotta get the hide, and then I gotta go get that red beacon. Fudge Six, get to the chopper! Fudge Six, we gotta run, dude! We gotta run! Bear, let's go, dude! Let's go, dude! Go! I don't know if we're gonna be able to make it. I don't think we're gonna be able to make the red beacon. I don't even know if I should be trying right now, but I am. Transfer literally everything! Whoa. What the fudge is this? Yo. Random Carno. And I'm just over here transferring my goods, and then this shit happens. Alright. I'll take all your hide, bro. Just when I needed more hide and some freaking raw prime meat. Why the fudge not? Alright, sure, dude.
Oh, get to the red beacon! Get to the red beacon! We're so close! That's red! That's fully red! Oh, I should not be spiraling my bird as much as I am right now. But he's so slow, because I put so much weight on his back! Go, bird, go! Go! You have like freaking 900 stamina! Wait, no!
It's this one. I hate my life. I hate my life. I hate my life. I hate my life. You know my life? I hate it. I don't like my life. You know the game is incredibly trollish when there is a red beacon that you cannot get to. You can't access this beacon. Trust me, I've tried. This is not the first time me trying either. Oh, I've tried. That's so stupid. This is by far, I think, the dumbest thing I've ever had to deal with. I am so salty right now. Alright. That's just another reminder to stay on task. Fudge you, Ark. You are a bitch. Alright, so we brought home the flint. We've also brought home a little bit of stone and a little bit of metal, actually. Kind of interesting, the whole theme going on right now, and we managed to bring back some metal. Also, really, really want to get cooking up on this, we're going to get cooking up on this prime meat, I think, right now. Let me go ahead and drop in a little bit of thatch. Light that fire up. We're not going to be able to use it to tame anything, so we might as well cook it up for ourselves, in all honesty, if we're going to be able to. I really should get a better fuel burner, so, yeah, either way. So, basically, what we're going to be doing right now is, what were we in the middle of? We were in the middle of, right. Arrows, that's what we were in the middle of. Okay, let's craft a bunch of arrows right now. So we can currently make, at the moment, 6, because I put everything into here like a dumbass. Wait, no, where'd I put everything? I don't know where I put everything. Where'd I put everything? Do I have everything in here still? No. Oh, it's all my inventory. What do I not have on me, though? Okay. So to be able to make an arrow, we need to have flint, thatch. Oh, we need the thatch. Okay. I've got a good amount of thatch, I'm pretty sure, stored away here somewhere. I think it's either in this chest. It's not in this chest. Where's my thatch? Thatch is right over here. Thatch is... I don't know where my thatch is. What do I do with my thatch? My thatch was inside of the campfire. Like, my memory is like 2 seconds long, basically. So, either way, what we're gonna... Is that red? That's a purple. Okay, well, you nearly got my hopes up right there. Okay, so, inventory items, craftables, let's see what we're gonna need right now. We'll be able to make a total of 50 more arrows, which is very, very good. We'll hold on to these right now. We might honestly need a bit more thatch to make some more arrows, but we don't want to hold too many on us. What I want to do for the time being, though, this is probably really loud and I apologize. We're gonna go ahead and drop in here real fast. We're gonna put away our long neck rifle. I have to keep my sword on me because it is a weapon, but I am gonna, don't want to put my pick in, nah, we'll keep the axe and pick on us for right now. We can go ahead and keep that, but, yeah, basically, what we need to go ahead and do, that's very nice that it's finally done, is, now we gotta make the parachutes, and the parachutes are the most vital thing, and the more and only more that we can hold on our, bird, basically, the better, pretty much. So, let me go ahead and, drop this rotten meat. We can actually make some narcotics in the meantime. Let's make 7. Why not? So, yeah. Basically, to make a parachute, we're gonna need ourselves, hide, fiber, and thatch. And I believe thatch is the one thing that I currently do not have a very good supply on. So, I might go ahead and, try knocking down some trees, getting some thatch right now. Because I actually don't think that I really have any. So, let's go on a bit of a thatch run. And I think we'll be good to go, guys. Just realized that my dire bear had, like, 150, 250 narco berries left. So, we can actually use the rest of those. Transfer those guys up in there. How many more can we make? We made a total of 37. Get some more narcotics, baby. We're actually just about to level up. So, even though the potions don't really work well for leveling up in specific, looks like we're gonna be able to finally, which is freaking awesome. Not exactly, so what level are we gonna be? We're gonna be at level 68. We're almost to that legendary level 69 because 2016 internet, man, come on. Alright, so at the moment, we'll be able to craft up 15 of these guys, mainly because, of anything, our fiber count is actually kind of low. The one thing that this bear is literally the best at is gathering fiber. Our fiber count's a little bit low. We've got literally, like, millions of fiber, basically, at home. A little bit less than a million, but kind of give or take around a small loan. Either way, we're gathering up. There's the level up, baby! Hey! What are we gonna level up, though? Not actually sure what I want to level up right now. Our stamina is still that. Our health is 300. Oxygen's 100. Meh. Food is 102. I don't really want to work on oxygen until I wind up getting into the sub-aquatics. Or aquatics, rather. Weight is 320. Melee damage is still 130. Movement speed is 120%. I'm going to go ahead and get our melee damage up a little bit more right now. I've heard melee damage is a very, very, very good thing to have. So, we're going to go ahead and do that. Especially the fact that I actually learned something new. Trikes are, not trikes rather, but pikes, the jousting weapon rather than swords, actually could be a lot better than swords depending on the use, because they actually have a further extended reach. So with pikes, you're a lot less likely to wind up getting hit by the target you're trying to fight, which is definitely something to look out for. I think Lachlan was experimenting that when he was trying to fight the caves. So we'll keep an eye on that. We'll definitely wind up carrying around that apprentice pike a little bit more. Not apprentice pike, but the, is it apprentice? Might be apprentice, I'm not even sure. The blue pike, basically. But yeah, I think we got enough thatch for right now. Let's go ahead and get back home, get our fiber count up, and I believe we're good to go. I think we're good to go. We got ourselves the arrows. We got the narcotics. The meat can come later on. That's fine. What else do we really... I don't really think there's anything else we need. We got the parachutes. Really, all you need is just a fully charged crossbow, which we have. A very good one at that. Arrows. Parachutes. And narcotics. I think that's all we need. Hey, Brandon, do you have any fiber? No, don't worry, man. I got you. Don't worry. I'll give you that good old Carlton fiber. Yeah, that good old Carlton fiber right there. But yeah, let's go and see how many we can craft up right now. A total of, where's it at? 25 parachutes. That's pretty freaking awesome. So we're going to go and craft up all those guys. They take a while to craft. We've already got 3, so that's going to give us a total of 28 of them. Now, the question is, I don't even know if I'm going to be able to carry all 28 on this pterodactyl. I know it would probably be better to tame an Argentavis from doing this. But you know what, my good buddy Choco, we need to keep a speed. I think we'll be fine on it, in all honesty. We'll see, though. It might not be. We'll have to see how much weight this guy can carry. But I think we should be able to squeeze just enough out of it if we count our blessings. Hopefully. You can't really go against fate, but hopefully at least. So I did have a little bit of a thought here. I may actually want to tame an Argentavis this episode, but we'll see. We'll see. But basically, the way I'm going to determine that right now is by how much of the weight my bird can hold right now while we're doing this. Because like I said, Argentavis, I believe, is by default 350 weight. And this guy right here, I think, is somewhere around 170 with his level, which is not really all that great at all. So what I'm going to go ahead and do right now is basically drop everything that I have. We got a lot of stuff on us that we really do not need. So let me go ahead and bring this over here. We probably should. I think we still have a bit more hide to work with. Yeah, if we want to get more parachutes, we can. But we'll go ahead and just for the time being is drop all of my items. Let's do it into this smithy right over here. The good old empty one needs a bit, little bit more loving. Transfer all the items right there. So what exactly? So we need the 8 parachutes right there. See, 20 parachutes is 60 weight. That's a lot of fudging weight right there. A lot more than you guys may actually think. So we have our apprentice crossbow right now. Primitive sword, metal pick, and metal hatchet. That's fine. We have our narcotics as well as our narco arrows. We got a little bit of meat for taming. We can go ahead and keep that. That's not too much weight right there. A little bit of cooked prime meat for ourselves. Might as well just hold on one or two right there. Not too much weight. 0.2. It's not that much. 50 more arrows if we want to make more later on. And we probably have to bring a few more narcotics as well. So let me go ahead and just take out the good old... I swear I've got more narcotics than that. Hold on, where are my narcos go? There's my other narcos. There we go. So yeah, if we went ahead and kept 500 narcotics on us right now, 50 weight right there. Our weight at the moment is 186. This guy in total can carry, not that. His weights, what can you carry? 184. And currently, right, the other problem you guys have to realize too is not only is the raw meat count for here, you need to keep him fed a little bit, but there's already 20 weight on this guy by default just from a saddle. I think we need to tame an Argentavis, as much as it's kind of unfortunate. Well, it's actually, I don't know why I'm so against wanting to tame one. It's necessary. It's needed. So I think we're going to wind up taming an Argentavis this episode. It's kind of like a big prep episode for the Quetzal, which I'm kind of fine with. But yeah, Chocodon, we're going to go ahead and I guess really, what box do I want to put this in right now? We can put all of our main stuff. This will be like our stuff for the big prep, you know what I mean? So let's go ahead and keep our narcotics on us right there. We got our raw meat. We got our arrows. We got, honestly, a lot of the stuff that we have right now, we can use for the taming of the Argentavis. So that's kind of funny right there. But yeah, parachutes and all that kind of stuff. We don't really need the parachutes for anything. Let me go ahead and put the raw meat inside of our mortal and pestle over here. So mortar and pestle. So yeah, an Argentavis is what I'm looking at right now. At a level 20, we'll take 9 of these crossbow tranks, which considering it's an apprentice crossbow with, what is it right now? A 1.4 times damage increase. Should be about maybe 7 or 6, maybe even less. So I guess really what the game plan is right now is to hop on our good old Pterodon and fly out and really just try try taming an Argentavis. Now, all the Argentavises are off in this direction over here. You know, you got the giant, pretty much the mountain of Argentavises. I don't know what level we're going to want to go for, but even though they're a bit slower, the wait is definitely worth it because, like I said, if we have to go back because we don't have enough of, or we couldn't bring enough of something, then that's a failure. Leaving a Quetzal could literally mean that it could either get eaten, or I've heard weird stories where they'll like pop out of unconsciousness for no reason whatsoever, even though they shouldn't. So terror stories like that really leave me, you know, kind of a bit concerned, considering this is a long process, and if for whatever reason it wound up not happening because of a bullshit thing like that, I'd be kind of heartbroken. So we got a level 11 Argentavis down there. I don't really know how we pick an Argentavis to go for. I guess, ooh, that's a beautiful one right there. You are a beauty. You are level, oh, it's a level 41. Fudge that noise. No, thank you. Do not need to spend too many arrows trying to tame an Argentavis for no good reason. Holy fudging, level 73 Argentavis, Batman. Check this guy out. Look at it, female, I should say. Level 73 Argentavis, oh man. I am such a sucker for higher level RGs, or higher level dinos in general, that I so badly, really kind of want to go for this one right here. Oh, Lachlan's on. Hey, I kind of really want to go for this Argentavis. Being that it's a level 73, might not work out the best for me, but I'm really tempted. Should I do it? I don't know if that's a good idea or not. I don't know if that's a good idea. But then again, it is kind of a level 73, which is really fudging awesome, because I like high-level dinos. And even though it's not... Is an Argentavis a dino? I don't really think so. I think it's just a bird. Trying to get a level gauge for what this guy is over here. You are an Argent... Okay, so we got level 5, nearly dead by those Sabertooths. That's a level 82! Huh! Oh, God, level 82 Sabertooth. Okay, well, that's a thing. That's a thing that exists. Right. That Argentavis down there was looking pretty good. I don't know, man. I don't know. So, from what I'm seeing around here, a level 73 would take around 21, apparently, of these Trank Darts to be able to work it. I think, you know, I think that sounds just good enough for me to be able to want to do it. So, we're going to go ahead and do it right now. What's up, my man? How you doing? Do you want some Trank Darts on you? I bet you do. Oh, I bet you do. Oh, come on. You want to do this right now? Or do you want to do... Oh, no. Hey. Wait, no. Hey, you're not supposed to be fighting my bird. Don't fight my bird. Fight me. Don't fight my bird. Fight me. Bird. Wait, no. Bird. Passive. Bird, you're passive. This is my fight right now. Actually, wait, no. I should probably make it neutral. Should probably make it neutral, actually. Okay. Bird. Bird. Do not kill this thing while I'm trying to knock it out right now. That's not what I need. Also, really do not want to hit my... Oh, no. Hey. Follow. Get down here. Come on, bird. Let's go. Bird. Yo, come on. What you gonna do right now? Hey, this ain't cool. Those guys are gonna fight. I'm pretty sure my bird will be fine. My bird should be fine right now. Although I'm not really sure how exactly to get my bird down from this situation. If I call him passive, does he come back down? No, he can't even pay attention to me while being passive. How do I do this then? Oh, are you coming down? There you go. That's what I'm on about. Alright, cool. So now the Argentavis is coming back right now. Just so Topor was going down kind of low. Alright, let's just see how this goes. Wait, hey, who's fighting? Oh, is this guy? Okay, wanted to make sure. All right, no, hey, don't go for my bird. Don't go for my bird. Neutral. I should check the health of my bird before I did anything, but I think my bird fine? My bird is more than fine. Perfect health, actually. And this Argentavis is on the freaking run right now. Okay, bird, let's go. All right, now how does this work exactly if I need to get the Argentavis? The Argentavis is so hurt right now. The Argentavis is so hurt right now. You know the Topor is low. You know when the Topor is low. Right. We just got to get this guy down, honestly. Now, there's some bad creatures around here. Was that a shot? That was a miss. We freaking missed that shot. Are you serious? Come on, get that one right there. Is that a shot? Is that a missed shot? Are you mad? Are you mad? All right, bird, come on. We're following it. We want to make sure the topor doesn't go down, but this bird is not healthy whatsoever. Come on, here we go. Yeah, right there. Right there. Come on, let me out. Let me out. Right there. There we go. Come on. Are you down? Yeah, baby. We got it. Little 73 unconscious. That health, though, is low. That health is low as all hell. Either way, I guess really what the game plan is right now, we didn't bring any narcotics. Fudge. That's not good. We did not bring any narcotics. The topor, however, is actually going down incredibly low, and it's at 3200 max because it's a very high-level animal. We just want to make sure this thing does not get hurt. Okay, level 26 Pterodon. Okay, so taming right now. I guess we'll figure out very, very soon how well the taming effectiveness is going. You've eaten up none of this right now. Okay, so you still need to eat up a little bit of food. We'll wait for you to chomp on your first bite, which should be... actually, these Argentavises really lose food and topor very, very slowly. Wow, really slowly, actually. It's like a 0.3. Is that usually how it is? I don't actually know if that's usually how it is or not, but yeah. Little problem, though, is that we might actually need to go, I don't want to have to go back home because that's the one thing I said I wasn't going to do. But let's just see how much this taming meter increases by one food. Should be eating it up within, okay, so if you guys don't know, they eat food every 50. So this is at 42,000, or 4,200, rather. So when this gets to 4,150, that'll be when it eats the food. So we're at point, or we're at 3 right now, we're at 2, we are at 1, and it's going to go ahead and eat up. What's your taming meter going to go up to? That's not too bad, actually. It's not too bad. Plus 36 left. Oh, my God. We might get a level 100 Argentavis. We might get a... Oh. That's a dire bear. 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 That... Nope. That's a dire bear. Now, dire bears, if you guys don't know, dire bears are, they're peaceful. They are. But they're incredibly territorial. Meaning that if I get anywhere close to that dire bear, it is going to hunt me the fudge down. Now, granted, I should be able to just man fight it. I've got a sword as well as some pretty decent armor right now. What am I wearing? I'm wearing a flak helmet, hide shirts, chitin leggings, flak boots, and flak gauntlets. We're pretty okay in terms of gear and health. We're fine. But I don't want to have to. I really don't want to have to. I kind of have a special thing for dire bears in my heart. I really would just love to not wind up dealing with it. But we will have to keep a little bit. Is that a second one? No. Thought that was a second dire bear. I think it's just the one in front of us right now. No? Oh, that's one of these guys. Oh, what's up, my dude? What are you? You are a, I forget what these things are, but they're passive all around right now. But yeah, dire bear, kind of don't really want to go near us. We got to keep a little bit of an eye out, but let's go ahead and check on our Argentavis right now. See how this guy's doing. Let me hop off right now. Female, I should say. Taming, I think we're going to be able to tame it before it gets conscious again. I might really want to man fight this dire bear, in all honesty, because this dire bear is going to freak me out. I really don't want to have to. I really don't want to have to. I don't think this dire bear is going to attack my Argentavis, though, right? No, it's not going to attack. Okay, the dire bear is not going to attack my Argy. That's good. But it's very close to it, to the point where I think it's going to get angry at me very, very soon. Oh, I don't know if I like this. Okay, you're staying passive. Do not want you getting involved in this fight. Think I'm going to have to man fight this dire bear right now, which is going to suck. But I think we need to. I think we kind of need to. We need to man fight this Patchy, though. Wait, no, hey. Oh, you should not be following me. My bird should not be following me right now. Do not follow. Stop. Thank you. All right, Patchy. Patchy. I'm sorry to do this. I'm sorry to do that. I'm sorry to do it. I'm sorry to do it. Now. Okay. The dire bear's right there, and my bird is chilled now. Now, the unfortunate thing with the Argentavises, from what I'm looking at right now, is apparently, from what I'm seeing, these guys are actually going pretty low in the plus level for the taming effectiveness. It's only gone down 2.4%, right? But I think it started out at a level 37, I believe, which is well, it's actually incredible, but it's already down 2 levels just by being tamed up that small amount. I don't know whether or not we're going to be able to get this guy up to level 100. We'll have to see. But that may or may not be a good thing. Actually, I don't know if that'll be a good thing. Bear, listen. Dude. Bear. Listen, bro. Hey. Hey. You don't want to do this. You really do not want to do this. Oh, what's up, bro? Oh, what's up, bro? Oh, yo. We got tranquilized. All right. Tapor's gonna be a little thing I gotta pay attention to, right? Hey! Oh, no, 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 no. Hey, no, 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 no. Hey. Neutral. Whistle neutral. Whistle neutral. You're good. All right, you're good. Attack that mother sucker. Attack that mother sucker while I'm actually just genuinely stuck in this rock right now. Okay. I would break this rock, but I'm pretty sure I'd die. Okay, well, here's a little bit of a problem. Last time I was stuck in a rock like this, and I tried getting out, I died. Or when I broke it, at least, I died by fall damage. Now, here's the only problem, right? I gotta get my bird back. My bird's up there, although the bird is actually kicking the Argentavis' ass. Look at that, level 17, nearly dead, actually. So, as soon as my bird comes back down, oh no, I'm fine. Okay, I'm good. Is my Argentavis fine still? Argentavis is still beautiful. Thank you very much. And my, Pterodon, you gonna kill that thing? Pterodon should be able to kill that. Choco's got this in the bag, bro. Yo, Choco. I thought that was, like a death message or something. Choco? Did I tell it to follow me? I never told it to follow me. You're not following me. Come back here. Oh, I never told it to follow me. Come on, get down. There you go. I thought for whatever reason that, like, see, I didn't know you could actually, like, zoom in on a bird and it would pay attention like that. I thought you genuinely had to get back up to that height to be able to bring it down. Little bit of a good thing that I knew that, but yeah, we got our bird back. We're looking fine. But yeah, as for the Argentavis, though, from what I'm looking at the moment, like I said, the leveling is going down really low, which really, really sucks. I don't know what level it's going to be, but it's not going to be a level 100. At least I don't think so. We'll have to see. But this guy right now, the Topor is going down incredibly low, and the taming is actually going up pretty high. From what it seems, the taming bar is going up faster than the unconscious meter is going down. So we should be able to get this thing 100% tamed without feeding it any narcotics. Kind of surprising in all honesty, but cool nonetheless. So I'm just up here like I'm waiting for the Argentavis tame because there's literally nothing to do except just wait. And I shouldn't be doing this right because I'm trying to get more fit. Like, you know, I don't know if you guys can tell, but like I've kind of changed outfits because I'm like I'm working out a bit more lately. And I'm eating these things called, like, as you see right here, they're like pretzel snaps. They're called butter snaps, actually. They're pretzels, and they're like little, they're like kind of in snack form. I'd show you guys, but it gets out of focus. And they taste like butter, you know what I mean? Not like full butter, but like kind of like it. They're really salty, just like Lachlan's Tears. And they're really addictive. Like, I genuinely have a whole bag next to me right now. I usually only have carrots next to me, you know, the healthy choice, but these have replaced them. It says only 1 gram of fat, though. So, I mean, it has to be healthy, right? Sponsor, please. Find this company. Tweet this video to them on Twitter. I will take a sponsor. I will sell my soul. Give me free things, please. It's a little bit of a progress update. While I'm in the middle of eating all my snaps right now, the taming is about halfway done, a little bit more than halfway. Unconscious meter, yeah, we're going to be good not giving it any narcotics, which is awesome. And from what I'm looking at right now, we might actually be in the money because we've given it this much time. It's a little bit more than half tamed, and the level plus has gone down by 5. So if we do math, that difficult thing, and fill up the taming meter to the rest of it, then basically it's going to go down by 5 more. And that means it'll be down to 27 in total, which means 73 plus 27, we might actually get out of this with a perfect 100 level tame. Oh, the titles. The titles. Hmm. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Get the fuck off my bird. Get off my bird. Get off my bird. Get off my bird. Oh, my God. Yo. That wasn't fun. Sorry for swearing. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. I can't tell you guys how upset I am right now, okay? This saber tooth just came over and started attacking my Argentavis. And, well, guys, the dream is literally dead. This isn't the dream. The Argentavis. The Argentavis isn't dead. The saber tooth's dead. Fudge that asshole. Because you go ahead and take a look at my Argentavis now. You see a taming effectiveness? 32%. the amount of rage, the amount of tilt that I'm on right now. Literally because of that stupid Sabertooth. We lost our level 100 tame. I'm so sorry. I don't know what to tell you, but I'm just sorry. Even the game's raining now. Everybody's depressed. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we are nearly at the end of our depressing Argentavis tame. Now, granted, it's still going to be a level like 84, basically. 83 or 84. I just so badly wish it was at 100, and I'm so upset that it's not. All because of that just one damn set. I tried killing that thing as fast as freaking possible. This thing's been like a 40-minute tame. Okay, not really. More like a 20-minute, but still, that's pretty long. 20, 25 minutes. It's been kind of insane. So what we need to go ahead and check out right now, though, is I actually have to go ahead and learn up the engram for an Argentavis saddle and see what exactly it is that I... Ooh, large elevator platform. Very, very cool. Let's go ahead and see exactly what I need to be able to craft this. So we need... 350 hide, 150 chitin, and 185 fiber. The hide can be done pretty easily. Chitin might be a little bit difficult trying to find all of that, but also keratin works as well, so that's kind of interesting, so we might be able to use that too. And the fiber as well, 185. It's not too bad, in all honesty. It's really not all that bad, although I am a little bit salty that I did just spend all that time making parachutes with the hide that I had. So I might have to go on a little bit of a killing spree, especially around here too. But either way, we're nearly ready to call this guy our own. Gonna be eating up right now, and there it is, baby! We got ourselves our first Argentavis. I am so stoked. I am so freaking stoked for this. Okay, so you turned out at the end Argentavis. Saber Rip. Is that a good name? Saber Rip. Saber Riptooth. Riptooth? Riptooth. Riptooth. That's a badass name, actually. Riptooth. Actually, does it need to be, I think it's like this. Is that Riptooth? I don't know. I think the proper way of doing it is like this, but I think you're supposed to as well, like, do it maybe, Riptooth? I don't actually know how I'm gonna do this. You know what? For right now, we're gonna go ahead, not Riptit. Oh, God. Riptooth is going to be your name. We got good old Riptooth over here. Level 84. What are your stats, my man? 448 weight. 160 melee damage. Really, Dire Bear? Dire Bear, don't do it. Dire Bear, don't do it. No, don't. We were almost so good. We were almost so good. And this guy just has to do it. I didn't want to have to. But this guy can literally kill anything of mine within a couple seconds. Fudge, that aggravates me. Like, even how's my Pterodon doing after that? No, my Pterodon's fine. Still, though, my Argentavis is at half health after that monstrosity. Everything about this just went so wrong when it needed to go so good. We were just about to leave too, and the bear was fine, and it just comes out of nowhere. That's unfortunate right there. But either way, that's a good amount of hide. We can go ahead and grab the hide from right there as well as the raw meat. Probably should have used the axe. I'm a little bit of an idiot. Okay, so lost a little bit of hide on that. We got some raw meat, so that's fine. I don't have enough to get the saddle for the Argentavis right now, so we're going to go ahead and fly it back home. This episode, by the way, guys, has nearly been going on for about 2 hours. Oh, God, the blinding. Oh, the blinding light. I swear I have bloom quality down. I'm so sorry, guys. But yeah, this episode right now has been going on for, I'd say, around 2 hour recording. So we're going to tip it off very, very soon. We're going to end it off by going over to... the red beacon. I think we're gonna end it off with this. Wait, no. We're gonna get the red beacon, and then we're gonna go back home, and we're gonna make the Argentavis saddle, and that's how we're gonna end off the episode, okay? So let's go ahead and grab this guy up right now. Red beacon. Level 60 bless up. Oh, oh! Take over inventory. Little bit of lag. Primitive shotgun. It's only primitive? Are you serious? Fudge, that makes me upset. It's only a primitive, 110%. Really, and a birthday candle, of course, and a scope attachment. That is really depressing. A primitive out of a red? Are you mad? All right, well, a little bit of some upset right there. What do you have in you right now? You got a stone hatchet. Why do you have a stone hatchet in you? That's so odd. Maybe you kill something and drop a stone hatchet? I have no idea. There's a second red one.
I love this game. Do you know why? This game is so unforgiving. Ark is such an unforgiving game. But then you have weird shit like this that happens where, like, first off, we lost our level 100 tame. That's depressing enough as it is. And then a dire bear comes out of nowhere and we have to kill that. Meh. Very, very minimal tilt. But then right after, the game's like, hey, I'm sorry about what I did. Here's two red beacons. Now, granted, they might not even have anything good in them. The first one, we all know, did not. But, like, what is this game that I'm playing right now? It doesn't make any fudging sense. So that beacon right now, as you guys can see, or you can probably tell, is not dropped yet. So we're going to go and spend some time trying to craft a saddle up right now. Argentavis should be following. Is the Argentavis following? Yeah, okay. Following through the... thank God you can actually see him from down there. Okay, so... Rip Tooth is going to go ahead and come over here. That's such a good name. I really like that name. We got our... Settle your differences. You're both friends. You're both friends, all right? You're fine? Yeah, you're fine, okay? Settle your differences. You're okay. So, to be able to make a saddle, we're going to need, again, 185 fiber, which we have, 350 hide, which we probably don't have, and 150 chitin or keratin. So, let's go and check us out right now. So, as for the chitin or keratin, we got 38 in our inventory right then. That's what we do have on us. We have 3 keratin. Don't really want to use that, but if we have to, I will. That's okay. The fiber we can go ahead and take on us right now, so we got enough of that. We have 3 more of these guys, so we can go ahead and bring those over. Really don't want to have to use those, but again, I will if I need. Right, what's left we got inside of here? I should have more. Do I have more chitin? I better have more chitin. Do I really not? Don't tell me that I don't. Are you serious? Do I not have any more chitin? Hold on a second. I'm just going through my inventory right now. We have 13 more of these guys, so that's not that bad right there. No more chitin, though, which is a little bit upset. We do have some more hide in here, which is nice. We have a good amount of hide. Oh, how many? We have 285 hide, which is a lot right there. Now, the chitin, though, is kind of actually upsetting me. We got 12 more in here. What did I use my chitin on? I think I might have used it on repairing my leggings. No, that doesn't actually take too much. No, I wouldn't have done that. The fudge. What did I spend all my chitin on? What did I spend all my chitin on? I swear I don't have any more chitin in here. I don't have any more chitin in any of this, which is actually a little bit kind of disturbing, if in all honesty. We have no more chitin. We do have all the hide that we need. We have the hide, and we have the fiber. We need 70 more chitin or keratin, which I believe we're going to have to go on a little bit of a run for. So, right. To be able to make the saddle then, what are we going to need to do? What can we throw away that we do not need on us right now? I guess we can go ahead and take the wood and put that inside of here. We're going to go ahead and get ourselves a little bit less weighted. The primitive shotgun we can put away right there. Again, meh. I'm kind of throwing things into a little bit of fire. Pelt right now, it's fine. Throw away the wood, so we're looking good on that. Argentavis, I'm going to tell you to go ahead and stop for right now. You can go ahead and be whistled neutral just so you're fine. We're going to go ahead and bring our good old pterodactyl. So we're going to go out to the shoreline right now and basically try and find any animal that would give us chitin, pretty much anything with a shell. And see, oh, no. We need to get the red beacon. We need to get the red beacon first, and then we'll get the chitin. So let's go and see this red beacon as for us. Honestly, like, it really is one of those things, you know what I mean? Ark is so unforgiving. It's an incredibly difficult game, but then you just have things like, they go wrong, and then they go really right. If this red beacon has something amazing in here for us, I will forgive the game of all its woes, but if the beacon has just, like, absolute crap in it, I'm gonna hold a pretty big tilt fest. So, let's go. Ooh, that might have chitin right there. Okay, actually, I don't know if that guy will have chitin or not. Here we go. Let's see what we got. 3, 2, 1. Access inventory. C4 charge. And a blueprint, though. Wait, hold on. Just saw something. What was that blueprint for? Blueprint for a refrigerator. I rate that. That's less engrams. That's not too bad. I like that a lot. We're actually being chased by Sabretooth right now. All right, Saber. Saber. You wanna go, dude? You wanna go, Saber? I know you're level 53 and stuff like that, but, like, you're fine, dude. Literally, I can just tank you if I need to right now. Let's go ahead and get all that. Not actually a lot of hide from you. How you doing, Choco? Choco, how you doing? You are doing, pretty good so far. Now, you... How much, you don't give chitin, do you? You give, what's it called? You give the, what is it called? The keratin to you? No, you actually... You give that much raw meat, but you don't give anything else. I'm actually appalled at this point. Holy fudge. Now, I don't think trikes give keratin, but I'm gonna try anyway. Let's go, trike. There you go. You don't give...
Yeah, no, you definitely do not. Oh, hello. You're mad at me too now, aren't you? Yes, you. Level 76 strike. You're not a high enough level for me to be interested. I've already got a level 82 of your kind. I don't need you. We got carrot. Okay, so yeah, these guys drop carrots. That's what I thought right now. Let me go ahead and get a little bit more of that. So that's two more right there. You are doing perfectly fine on health. Right. We can't be. This is not the area to be looking at right now. We need to find. Yeah, we need to find some more chitin. Chitin. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't even know if it is. So the one thing I actually forgot was these guys right here, the trilobites, actually drop a pretty good amount of chitin. So we can go ahead and kill these guys right here. And then I believe use the axe on them. And this 29. 29 from these guys, and they're right here on the shore. I knew it wasn't this hard to get chitin. I knew it wasn't. I just had to figure out where to get it from. Okay, so we need, how much more do we need? How much more do we need with this? We need 39. So we'll kill maybe about two more of them, and then we should be pretty much good to go. This is a matter of like trying to find these guys in general. So let me see around here. Piranhas around there. Those guys are going to come chasing me soon. No more of them around here from what I can at least... Oh, here we go. We got another one. All right, cool. Let me go ahead and kill you up. We got level 8. There we go. Probably actually use the sword on him, but that's okay. 27 more kites in, and then we got to go ahead and kill one more. Is there any maybe down here under the water? Ooh, whoa. Deep ocean. Deep ocean. Definitely got to be careful. Do not need a shark coming around and murdering me. That would not be good at all. Not seeing any of them down here, unfortunately. Not seeing any of them down here. Let me go ahead and call over my pterodactyl. Where's my pterodon? There you go, my man. Go ahead and follow me over. Thank you very much. All right, so we need one more. Just one more, and then we'll be 100% good to go. Let me go and duck down a little bit more. Nope, not seeing any more. Still okay. Oh, wait, was there another? That's a rock. Okay, that was a little bit of a rock right there. Anything else? Kind of bugging me a little bit right now, but I think I see one over on the other end of the shoreline I'm going to go chase right now. Just got to make sure there's nobody else. Oh, we got dodos. What's up, dodos? How you doing? Was it a dodo that I saw? Might have actually just been this dodo over here and not an actual trilobite. Is there a trilobite underneath here? No trilobites at all. Damn, they're high. They know I'm on the hunt. They know I'm on the hunt for that last bit of chitin, and they are staying scared right now. All right. Where are you guys at? You underneath here? I know. There you are. There you are. We got three of them. Three of them to end it off. And a shark out that way. I know they're not called a shark, but I can definitely see it out there. Let me go ahead and kill him. There we go. There we go. And let me get that good old chitin. There you go, baby. 22 of it. That should be enough. Yes, it is. Craft up that saddle, baby. We got ourselves an Argentavis saddle, which is so freaking sick. And we got a total of 10 chitin left. Don't know if I'll have enough weight to be able to get back home on my pterodon right now. Should be able to, at least, I think. There we go. Ride him over. This is actually a pretty long episode, so hopefully you guys are okay with that. I mean, I don't really know why you wouldn't be. Longer episodes are better than shorter ones either way. So we're going to go ahead and end it off right now. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. We're just going to go and drop the saddle on our Argentavis and really see how fast the Argentavis is. I know they're slow, but I want to see the comparison. I have to see the comparison right now. Come on. Here we go. Come on over to me. There you go. Come on. Come on. Come on. There you go. There you go. Stop for me. Looking good. Perfect. So now let's go ahead and drop us on right now. Got the saddle up. Looking great. Hop on for the ride. And how fast are you? That's actually not too bad. That's really not too bad. Like, in all honesty, that's kind of a good comparison between what my pterodon is when it's really weighted down. It's definitely not as fast, but it's still pretty damn good. So guys, we got ourselves a level 84 Argentavis. Drop a like if you're excited for tomorrow's episode of Trying to Tame a Quetzal. Now, I don't know where we're going to find one. I don't. But all I know is we've gotten all the tools that we need. We have the narcotics. We have the parachutes. We have the transportation. We have the ammunition. And we have the fortification. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode of ARK on the YouTuber Survival Server. I'll catch you all back tomorrow for another episode. Ciao!